Recall that the effect of running any function with the keyword new is that that function runs as if it had a bit of extra code in it. Particularly, it's going to set the keyword this to equal some brand newly created object. Just because we ran the van function with the keyword new and created another, different object, does not mean that the other function is going to run with that same object as its context. These are two different object.create statements that are being inserted into two different functions, as a result of two different appearances of the keyword new. In the diagram, this would mean that anytime you run the van function, with or without the keyword new, it would have the effect of building a brand new object that delegates to the constructor of the car class. If you're running the van function with the keyword new to begin with, then you've already got a brand new object and you don't need a second one. Sometimes people try to solve this by assigning the result of the new car invocation, this object that gets created during the car constructor, assigning it to the local keyword this. But not only is it disallowed to assign to the keyword this at all in your own code, even though the interpreter is allowed to do such things, it doesn't solve the fact that you wind up having two different objects, one of which you would apparently be throwing away. So this solution just doesn't work. Simple enough. What if we were to call the car function without the keyword new? Perhaps that would have the effect of simply running the car function in the context that we wanted. Unfortunately, this doesn't work either. In this situation, what would you expect the keyword this from within the car function to be referring to as a result of being invoked on this line?